to earnings. So let's join in the management of PTC. Joining us now is Mr. T.N. Thakur to talk more about the quarter gone by. Mr. Thakur, thanks very much for speaking with us. So we just have your fourth quarter performance with us. If you could walk us through what sort of realizations you've clocked in this quarter.
No, we have done very well as regards the volumes are concerned. The volumes have grown by 47% on quarter-to-quarter basis. And even if you add all the four quarters, then corresponding year, last year it was 13.8 and this year it is going to be 18.2 billion units of trade. And you would have noticed that last year itself it was 40% rise. So to that extent, our volumes are growing, which is a very healthy sign of the growth of our business. But if you look at the profit before tax or the other profit after tax, those figures are slightly down because of the impact of tax and as well as the lower treasury income. Now, our treasury income has gone down because of the prevailing market situations. As you know, the interest rates have fallen, and we had to pay higher tax because most of our earlier treasury investments were equity related. But later on, we shifted to fixed income related, the debt related, because that's what our investment committee and our audit committee wanted for more security of capital. And therefore, we have to pay more tax now. Because of the lower treasury income and the higher tax incidence, in spite of our very high operating income, from 22 crores in the last quarter, it has gone to 60 crores. So even though it was three times increase in the operating income, but our profit before tax has increased only by 2.5 crores roughly on quarter-to-quarter basis and by about 16 crores on annual basis because of the two factors that I just now mentioned.
Sure. Mr. Thakur, could you throw some more light on what the realization stand at this quarter? Because the street was expecting a figure of about almost 4.8 rupees per unit.
No, you see, let's not go by the top line because I have been, you can appreciate that our main income is from margin and the top line depends on the price of power in the market which fluctuates. Now last year, this quarter ended, the price was on the lower side. We were finding it difficult to sell power even at 5 rupees and 5 rupees 50 paise and people were not taking it. But now the prices have gone up to, on the exchange, to 13, 14 rupees. And in the bilateral, we are able to attract 7, 750. So I am not very particular about the top line because that's only an indicative of the shortage situation and the desperation of the people about power. So what is important really is our margin. Now on the margin till 31st March, we were charging only 4 paise as per the earlier regulation. And now that you know that the regulation has been revised and for trade of selling price up to 3 rupees, we can charge only 4 paise and beyond 3 rupees, we can charge 7 rupees. So from 1st of April, we have started charging 7 rupees on the short-term trade. And therefore, even if the volume is the same, our margin income will be higher in the current quarter or in the current year. So that is an indication of, again, a healthier financial results of this company in the coming quarter or the year. And the volumes in any case are growing. And as I said, that this growth of volume is a trend now. Last year, as I told you, that was a 40% growth. This year, again, is almost 33% growth.
Sure.
And this is going to be the trend because of the projects getting commissioned from where we have PPA. For example, the Lanco Unit 1, we have a PPA. That project got commissioned and that power is being sold through us from the 31st March or 1st of April. So that's a 300 megawatt of additional power we are getting this financial year. Some more projects are getting commissioned and those soon also will add it. In addition to whatever we are able to take from the short-term market.
Right. So Mr. Thakur, that's precisely what I was coming to, sir, because you did say your trading margins stand at about 0.4 paise. Last quarter, you changed the guidance to about 0.7 paise. If you could reiterate in little more detail, what's the impact that you've seen this quarter?
No, this last quarter, that quarter, which the results of which we are talking about now, on the basis of limited audit, as I said, till the end of that quarter, we were charging only 4 paise according to the earlier regulation, because we had the existing contracts where we had mentioned 4 paise. So even though the regulation later allowed us to charge higher margin, we could not have done it because these were all ongoing contracts. Now, whatever contracts have been signed in March for flow from 1st April onwards, there we are charging 7 paise. Right, and we can charge up to 7 paise. I am not saying that in all cases we will charge 7 paise, because it will depend on again the market acceptability and also the competitiveness, but we have been successfully able to charge 7 paise in most of the cases, except the power that we get from Bhutan, where according to the long term agreement we cannot charge more than 2.5 and 2.75, as you know already. So therefore, this margin impact, increased margin impact, you will see in the first quarter of this year and not in the last quarter of the previous financial year. And that is why I am not talking about that now.
Sir, if you could also get us a status on Ashmore of the US. You were supposed to launch a power sector fund. What's the kind of amount that you're raising and what's the status really?
Look, of course, I'm on television, so most of the people will be seeing it. I would not have liked to say about the quantum of fund that we are wanting to raise. Our mental target is 1 billion, but I know that maybe in first close we don't achieve more. So what I have been thinking, that by September, whatever we are able to achieve, we will close, the first close we will achieve by 30th September. And the joint venture agreement has been signed already. And we have in the pipeline any number of projects where the developers want equity. So therefore, whatever we are able to get in the first tranche, we deploy fast and then go for the second tranche of the equity raising. In the fundraising. So I would not say about the size of the first close at this point of time, because we are still doing soft marketing. And after we got SEBI's clearance, we will be applying to SEBI shortly. Then we will start the real marketing.
So by when can we expect the formal launch?
I think towards the end of this May, we hope that we should be able to launch.
Mr. Thakur, what about the financial services IPO? When can we hear from that?
The financial services IPO, we have taken the decision in the board that we'll do it during the current financial year. And they have already started preparations. And we will like to do as soon as we can. But I don't see it happening before the second quarter of this financial year. But as I said, that we'll try to do as quickly as we can.
And Mr. Thakur, last question, sir. You had earlier indicated that you are looking at acquiring some coal blocks abroad. Any progress on that?
Yes. Yes, there has been substantial progress. We have already, we are very close to clinching the deal on a couple of mines, and maybe as soon as we have finalized the final terms, we will go to the next board meeting, or sometime in May or early June, we will have a board meeting where we will take this proposal.
Okay, thanks Mr. Thakur for joining us. That was PTC India for you. They've come out with their numbers. And next quarter onwards, that's coming this quarter, we can see some improvement in margins as they can now charge 7 paise. But it's time to